Good day, and welcome to the Sean Farrell podcast. I am Sean Farrell. God is great all the time. All the time, God is great. Jesus Christ is Lord. Let's not waste no more time. Let's get right to it. So I saw all this post at the beginning of April. Okay. And it was from mental health CEO. Someone I follow on Instagram, okay? And this was the post. It said 160,000 people have died by suicide since the start of 2024. Okay? Every day, around 1,900 people die by suicide across the world. Suicide is not an issue isolated to rich countries. 77% of all suicides occur in low to middle income countries. Suicide is the fourth leading cause of death amongst young people ages 15 through 29. Keep in mind that all these figures only account for the suicides which are reported, okay? There are so many others where they are not reported, so that 160,000 could be higher. Could be higher. The ones that were reported, the 160,000 which were reported, but the number is higher for the ones that haven't been reported. For every suicide, there are countless suicide attempts. This doesn't have to be the case. Check in on your family, friends, even those who seem to look okay, because suicidal has no look. Okay? Suicide has no look. We all thought Robin Williams was living well. Yeah. Suicide has no look. I've showed up to work. I've showed up to work suicidal, but people can never tell because you just smile through the stuff that you're going through. Okay, you smile through the stuff that you're going through. So they assume everything is going okay, when inside it's actually not. Don't be afraid to ask about suicide. Don't use stigmatizing language. Educate yourself on the warning signs. Be supportive, not judgmental. Okay? If we can do all those things, then we can... then a lot more people would be willing to open up about what they're going through. But as long as we use things like what they call positive, toxic positivity is what they call it. Toxic positivity, where you say some positive things, but it really doesn't address the pain that they're feeling. It kind of minimizes it or dismisses it altogether, dismisses their pain altogether. So, yeah, let's have more conversations. Let's have... let's not be dismissive. Let's not be judgmental, okay? You know, suicidal versus suicide. The person is suicidal. Then you dismiss them. Then they die by suicide. And then you say, I wish I saw all the signs. But the signs were there. You just didn't take it seriously. You dismissed it. So every 40 seconds, someone ends your life, and every 41 seconds, someone is left to make sense of it. So yeah, let's talk about suicide. Let's kick stigma in the ass. Also saw all this, the meaning behind the butterfly. Okay, they associate butterflies with mental health. Suicide, yeah, they associate the butterfly with mental health, suicide, anxiety, depression. Just when the caterpillar thought her life was over, she began to fly. Okay. The butterfly is proof that you can go through a great deal of darkness, okay, and yet still become something beautiful. Give yourself time. Don't be afraid. Change is beautiful, said the butterfly. Okay. The butterfly is a symbol of freedom, transformation, and rebirth, and a new beginning. Okay. And so, kind of like when a caterpillar is in the cocoon about to become a butterfly, and it's trapped, and it's trapped. The cocoon is, the caterpillar is trapped in the cocoon. And sort of like depression. You feel like you're trapped. You feel like your life is over. And just a dark time. But all of a sudden the cocoon starts to crack, if you will, and something beautiful comes out. So for those of you who feel like that your life is over, just think about the caterpillar, the cocoon, the butterfly. The caterpillar thought their life was over when they turned it into the cocoon, but then the cocoon cracked and a butterfly came out. So yeah, as well as the semicolon, okay, semicolon. A semicolon represents a sentence an author could have ended but chose not to. Okay, so I remember for my birthday, a friend gave me a frame of a saying that said choose to keep going, and it had a semicolon. Okay, semicolon, continuation of life, a decision to keep moving forward and not get giving up. And for the people who out there who are really struggling, okay, it's hard, it's gonna be difficult, but I'm telling you, it is worth it, okay? It is so worth it, because you matter more than you ever know. You all matter more than you ever know. You may not realize it right now, okay? But you matter. You are loved, and you are, and you matter, okay? And lost my train of thought. Dang it. Forgot what I was about. I'll just say next. But yeah. You are enough. You matter. You are loved. Okay, now I know what I want to say. It's just that depression is filtering out any good that you may see in yourself, okay? But you matter. You're loved. You're more than enough, okay? All right. All right. That's it. That's all for the Sean Farrell podcast. I am Sean Farrell. May God bless you all. See y'all on the next one. I am out of here.